I'm Al John Goh, co-host of the Disney List podcast as heard on Sorcerer Radio, as well as Skull Rock podcast, here with my wife, Kristen. Hello.
Hello.
You are an earmarked agent who books Disney travel vacations for people all the time. Give our listeners a reason why they want to give you a call instead of just booking a trip by themselves.
Well, I can do all of the legwork for them. I have expertise. I've been to the Disney parks well over 100 times, so they've got that knowledge at their hand, as well as it saves them time and money.
Where can people get in touch with you so that they can book their next Disney cruise, Disney park trip, Adventures by Disney?
They can contact me at themeparksandcruises@gmail.com. I'm Kristen Hetzel, vacation planner, world traveler, Disney foodie, and theme park fan.
I'm Al John Goh. I'm the husband who's also Disney, Star Wars, and Marvel Comics fan. And together, we host a Disney List podcast.
Every week, you'll hear us list our favorite things about Disney theme parks, films, shows, travel, Marvel, and Star Wars in a top 10 list, rankings, and more.
That's an impressive list. Subscribe to the Disney List podcast on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, iHeartRadio, or your favorite podcast platform. You can even stream us on Sorcerer Radio at srsounds.com and check out our live shows on Facebook. The Disney List Podcast. Visit thedisneylist.com.
The Dining at Disney Podcast. The Dining at Disney Podcast. You'll discover all the best restaurants and food as you really explore the Disney parks.
Let's do this thing!
The Dining at Disney Podcast with your hosts, Kristen, Bubba, and Kat.
Welcome to the Dining at Disney podcast. I'm Kristen. With me is Bubba and Kat. If you haven't already, make sure you like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you know when we share new content. Bubba, how are you doing?
I'm giddy right now. I have less than a week till I'm back at the happiest place on earth, so I'm very happy.
And how about you, Kat?
Doing well.
So I noticed that this time on Facebook, we can actually comment. The little write a comment thing has appeared, which is like completely new because every other time people post comments to us and it won't let us comment back. Does yours have it now, Kat?
I still can't see the comments.
Mine says no comments yet. So
yeah, mine doesn't have any yet. But do you see where you can write a comment now?
No.
Down at the bottom?
I don't have that.
Why do I have it now?
You're probably the, I don't know, moderator?
I don't know.
It likes a lot better.
You gotta love technology.
Nope.
Especially since it kicks you out every week.
Yeah, exactly. Every time we hit record, boots me out and I have to knock my way back in.
Well, this week we are talking about what will be open when Disneyland reopens, as well as some information on May the 4th. So, where do we want to start, guys?
Oh, let's just start with Disneyland opening tomorrow. Yeah, you can't help but just feel the magic in the air here in California. I'll tell you that. Sorry, everybody outside of California. But you'll get your chance. I'm sure maybe in July you'll be able to come to the park. But for right now, just Californians for the next 2 months. And I'm very excited. I'll be there Monday, Tuesday. I have a few friends going tomorrow for the grand opening, which is going to be not insane because we're only at 25% capacity. So you're just going to have a lot of people maybe hang out in the Esplanade that didn't get reservations. But yeah, it's going to be very exciting tomorrow. I can't wait to see I've already seen the cast members. I guess cast members got to go yesterday and today, and they're just posting stuff left and right. Just how happy they are that they get to enter the park. You know, they go under the train and they start crying. Disney released a video a couple days ago. And at the end, they played this little touching memento where it's got everybody crying. So I don't know if you guys watched it. It was very sentimental at the end, you know, just it's we're, it's been over a year, and I just can't help but be excited now.
It's crazy that it's been that long, because I remember when it all started and I was like, there's no way that Disney World or Disneyland is going to be closed that long.
I know.
Yeah. But at that point, I'm not thinking that the government's going to like not allow businesses to open, you know?
No, but they stayed closed.
But they did. Yeah.
Well, Disney World, I forgot when they opened, reopened. But yeah, it's just
July.
July. See, not even that long. What, three months they were closed.
And which is, it's still crazy. It's still crazy that they shut down for that long.
I know. But still, a year, March 14th, 2020, the day that lives in infamy for Disney fans. Because we were supposed to go 3 days later and it didn't happen, but oh well. We're going in 3-4 days, so we're just we're very excited and just can't wait to be there. So we actually have a list, and it's a very long list. I think I sent you guys a list too of what is closed at California Adventure and at the Disneyland Resort and the hotels too. So let's go over that real quick, if you guys don't mind. So if you are going to the parks in the next few weeks, they did announce that Blue Bayou will not open. They haven't announced a date, have they, Kat, of when it'll reopen?
I haven't heard anything exact. I just know that they're saying summer.
Summer.
Oh. Summer. Well,
that'll be Memorial weekend then. Hopefully it'll be open by then at the end of May. So
I would think that they would try to get it open on or before Avengers Campus opens so that they could get more people to eat there instead of... I'm sure the crowds at Marvel Campus is Avengers Campus is going to be big for food. So,
Oh yeah.
Maybe the draw for Blue Bayou and their booze and whatever they have going on is going to.
Oh yeah. Because the only thing new is booze, right? They're going to be serving hurricanes and selected wines and stuff like that. Yeah.
But you never know. They might have seasonal menu items. They haven't announced anything else. So.
Or seasonal drinks, maybe. Yeah,
exactly. Kind of
like how Parfait does it. So just a few things. We'll go over California Adventures first. These are the attractions that will not be open. Grizzly River Run, unfortunately, will not be open. When we were there for Touch of Disney last week for the final day, they had water in there and they were testing everything. It was actually pretty cool. It felt great over there. You know, you can feel the wind and the water because we hung out for about a good hour right there because it was nicely shaded. It's a good spot to eat food. They set up a lot more tables at this time as opposed to the first weekend to the last weekend. There was plenty of places to sit for the final day of Touch of Disney. But yeah, like I said, Grizzly River was closed, Golden Zephyr, the Red Car Trolley, Redwood Creek Challenge Trail, Sorcerer's Workshop, Blue Sky Cellar, the Bakery Tour, which is one of my favorites because I love getting my piece of bread at the beginning, and the Animation Academy. Those will be closed. As for the dining experiences, here we go with the long list. So Carthay Circle will be open for fresco dining outside. Indoor will remain closed for the time being. Bayside Brews, this is the list of everything closed. Bayside Brews, Boardwalk Pizza and Pasta, Clarabelle's Hand Scoop Ice Cream, Corn Dog Castle, Fairfax Market, Fillmore's Tastin', the Fruit Carts, Jack Jack's Cookie Num Nums, their cookies are nice and huge. Have you had one of their cookies yet, Kat?
I can't have their cookies.
Never mind, you can't have it. Yeah, it's very delicious. Lemonade Cart, Lucky Fortune Cookery, Mendocino Terrace, which is our hangout to drink wines and stuff like that. Yeah. And it's a nice breeze up there because you're a little bit higher overseeing Cars Land. It's nice. Pacific Wharf Cafe, so no bread bowl for me. Paradise Garden Grill, the Pretzel Cart, Schmozy's, and the Turkey Leg Carts are going to be closed, which I can't believe that.
It seems to me because almost all those places have an abundance of outdoor seating.
Yes, they do.
To me that you would want to have them open.
It seems, you got to remember too, they cannot bring in cast members for 100% capacity.
Yeah.
It's only 25%. So of course they're going to have to be limited to the staff right now, which understandably, I understand that these are closed, but you're right. Mendocino Terrace, you could have one person working up there. It's outdoors. There's not even indoor. It's an outdoor place. Stuff like that. Yeah.
Is the Mexican place over at Pacific Wharf, is that open?
Cocina Cucamonga. That is right now open.
Makes sense then, because you've got one of those three places open.
Yeah, because Lucky Fortune Cookery is closed, and so is Pacific Wharf, which is crazy.
Aren't both of the places over by the, what is it, Boardwalk?
Paradise Pier.
Aren't both those closed?
Yeah.
You would think at least one of them would be open, because, again, that's a massive amount of seating there.
A lot of seating right there. I mean, yeah. It is. I mean, that's where everybody sat for Touch of Disney. It was a very popular area because you have the Carl Strauss beer truck right there. Mm-hmm. You have the margaritas right there too. Clarabelle's. So it's a very popular spot, but yeah, they're trying to just, looks like, keep the social distance. You know, they weren't too strict on it this time when we went for Touch of Disney, which was very different from the first time we went to the last. A lot of differences. So they're more relaxed, in my opinion, about social distancing and masks and stuff like that. So we'll see how it goes opening day. The shops, Julius Cats and Sons is closed. Oswald's, Sarge's Surplus. Those are closed. And then everything Avengers Campus is closed right now, too, of course. Doesn't open until June 4th. That's Pence Test Kitchen and Web Supply. So over in the Disneyland section, where do I have you? I think I just gave you guys the Disney California Adventure one, or California Adventure one. For Disneyland, here is what's closed. And just bear with me as I go down this huge list. Alien Pizza Planet, Blue Bayou, of course, Carnation Cafe, The Golden Horseshoe, Hungry Bear Restaurant, Rancho del Zocalo, Royal Street Veranda. Those are the main restaurants that will be closed. I know that we tried to get reservations for Orleans, and those went fast when reservations opened up. So you couldn't get anything for that. We did get the Riverbell Terrace. And I haven't eaten there yet, so I know it's a new barbecue place. So have you heard any good news or good reviews about that place, Kat?
I've heard nothing.
Yeah, I haven't heard anything about it either. So this will be the first for me. We did make reservations for that. What else? Food stands that are closed: Clarabelle's, Daisy's Diner, Edelweiss Snacks, Harbor Galley, Maurice's Treats, Pluto's Doghouse, Refreshment Corner, Tiki Juice Bar, Tropical Imports, Troubadour Tavern, all closed. So those are the outdoor places that, that, like I said, it's a long list. So you have your choice of, I don't see Plaza Inn on this list. So I am hoping that is open. It should be open. It's out, massive outdoor seating right there too. You could choose indoor or outdoor, but you know, it's a lot of outdoor seating right there. So I'm hoping that is open. Ronto Roasters is open, thank God. And Docking Bay is not on the list either. This is an updated list as of today, and Docking Bay is not on there either. So it looks like everything in Galaxy's Edge is going to stay open, thankfully.
Ronto's Roasters definitely on here.
Yeah, but it is on there?
I'm seeing Ronto's Roasters. I'm looking at the OC registered list. I just see Ronto's. I don't see Docking Bay, but I don't. Who knows?
Because I don't see Docking Bay on this, and I don't see Uga's Cantina. So I don't know if they're missing everything out on this list that I have, but we'll find out, I guess, tomorrow. definitely what is open and what is closed. And then we'll just go from there. I would figure if Oga's is open, they would have opened reservations up for that.
Yeah,
because you do need a reservation, because that place is busy from open to close.
Yeah.
So it's going to be very interesting, but I'm not going to worry about that. I'm just happy to be. I'll just be happy to be inside.
It always amazes me when Disney builds places like that they know are going to be popular. that they don't build them bigger, because Oka's is not very big at all.
No,
it's not.
And it's like they would make so much more money if it was a larger place. And that's what I don't get is I'm like, I always think in when it comes to that is in terms of how much profit you can make. And that would be a place that if you had twice as much seating, that's twice as much money being spent.
Yeah. But you also, there's a lot of people kind of staying there for, you know, 2 hours, maybe even 3 hours at a time also, which is why there's always a long wait. So yeah, more, they need, what do you call them? Booths or little cave booths, you know, kind of like how they have it set up. I like sitting in those too. We always sit in those. I don't really like the outside booths that you have to stand and drink. So we'll see what happens on Friday, tomorrow, when everything opens up.
I have a question for you guys, because I don't know the answer. At Walt Disney World, they're doing relaxation stations.
I heard they are going to have these. We actually asked about those, and they said they have them.
I think that might be why so much stuff at DCA is like not happening, because that back area towards the Pacific Pizza and Pasta over there by Bayside Brews, because Bayside Brews was open for Touch of Disney because we ordered stuff from there, and now they're not open. So I would lead me to believe that they're going to put the relaxation station, if there is one, back in that corner.
They'll probably put a couple up. Because that is a big area also to sit down, and it's well shaded too. I mean, you have so many trees over there. It's just, it feels really good over there just to sit and eat and hang out. They will have relaxation stations. Don't know where yet, but just to take your mask off and put your feet up and just relax.
Have a free day. Also, did Award Wieners change their menu back, or will they be the ones offering corn dogs?
I heard they are changing back to the hot dogs, but I also heard another one that they will be serving still corn dogs and the fried cheese stick. Because
corn dogs
You have to have their hot dogs there. They're just amazing.
That's what I'm saying. It's like,
hold on, Taylor found out that they are just doing corn dogs.
No, they're still doing
them. Oh, so they will have their hot dogs and they will have the corn dogs over there.
Cool.
So, yeah.
So speaking of masks, for those who have Disney stores nearby and are not in, you know, Orlando or Anaheim. So if you go to any of the Disney stores, like we've got the Disney store outlet at a mall here, and they have a really good deal going on with their masks. Now, I will say the majority of the masks are the kid size masks. Most of them are the smaller media, but they did have larges. We did not see, I don't think we saw one extra large mask, but they're charging anywhere from $1.48 to $2.98. for one mask, and then they had packs that had three or four masks in it for $7.98. And I ended up getting two. And mine are medium because I am a small person, that the masks always like ride up to my eye and like touch my eyes. So I got, look at the ones I got. This is a medium. This is the kid size one.
And that fits you perfect.
It fits me perfectly.
Snacks on it?
Yes, I got it. Yes, I am a certified snack tester. But yes, it has the snacks on it.
Oh.
And then, because you know it has to be foodie ones. Look at the other one. It's the Mickey Premium Bars.
That's awesome. But I like
a good deal. And they actually, you know, if you're somebody who is petite, a medium could easily fit your face. Like if you're like, I wear a youth hat because my head's not big enough for an adult head. So I didn't find this out till.
It's nice that you and the kids can share stuff.
Right. Right. Yeah.
I bought a lot of masks, though, when we went for the first Touch of Disney, first time. I bought 3 Star Wars masks, and I bought the blue Disneyland one. I love the Star Wars mask. I got a Darth Vader, and May the Force be with you. But the straps are way too thick for my ears to where they were starting to cut underneath my earlobe right here. So, I have them. I wear them sometimes. It's just when you get sweaty, it'll start.
Because it starts rubbing on your skin. Starts
chafing and roughing, yeah. But I love they have these dark blue Disneyland mask with the D on it and established. Those, the straps on there are perfect. They're a little bit more expensive. I believe they're $16 a mask, but they're so perfect. But then they have an extra large and it just fits perfect on my face. I wore it in my pictures. If you go to my Instagram, you'll see it in my pictures.
Well, Disney right now has on their website, you can get for a limited time Disney cloth masks. Anywhere from $11.99 to $19.99, yeah. They have for just $10.
Nice.
And I think, yes, they do have that, where it's got the stitch down the middle, right?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Those are $10, too.
Oh, what? I paid a grip for mine. But I got my AP discount.
Now, however, they don't have it in a color you would probably want, Bubba. It's pink.
Rose gold.
Nothing's wrong with blush or bashful. I like those two colors, pink and pink.
Love it.
I don't like that color pink. I don't like pink. I like the fact that it's got the rose gold on it. I think that's cool. But I'm not very much a pinky. I know, and I'm wearing pink today. I'm
like,
I don't
really what are you like wearing?
Pink. I hate pink.
Like, what are you wearing?
I like the hot pink that's more of like a red pink. I like. I do have this because I got this at the character warehouse in Orlando, you know, for like, I think $7 after Flower and Garden.
And I'm trying to go to character warehouse for like the better part of a year. And every time I go, it's like a 2-hour wait. We were there for 4 hours once and never got in.
Wow.
It's insane. I love that place though. I remember when nobody knew it was there. And so there was never a line and never crowds. And nowadays it's insane. And I can only imagine now, because you know they're going to have tons of 2020 merchandise that they had pre-ordered, you know, probably in like 2018 to be made. Yeah. And now they're going to have to send all of that.
I do miss the cast member store. I'll tell you that right now. Man, there was just all this stuff for cheap that you'd pay $40 more in the park. And oh, it was awesome. Miss those days.
Yes. I can't wait till I can actually go back to Orlando and go to the character warehouse place. I did get a really good price on a Dooney and Burke there. My Nightmare Before Christmas bag.
Oh, yeah.
Uh-huh. It's that the tote one. I got it for $48.
Wow.
I know, right?
Wow, that's really good.
Yeah, it is. But I'll tell you, Dooney and Burke is the one person I've had that those things, you can do so much wear and tear to them. And it totally takes it. And yeah, you can't tell. Because I've got like the one purse that I carry most of the year is like 4 years old now. And it looks brand new. You'd never. And it's a white one. It's got white with Mickey and Minnie and black and red. And it's got like the popcorn cart and stuff on it. Which is so why cute. I wanted it, because I was like, oh, I like that. But yeah, those things are well worth the money if you plan on carrying it, you know, want to carry something for a long period of time. Yeah.
I got the Marvel and Coach team up. I got the Frost Body from them and I love it so much. But I also got the Danielle Nicole Tink backpack a while ago. And my jeans turned the brown leather blue.
Oh no.
Wow.
That's awful.
That's not real.
The Coach one is white and black and it hasn't done that. But the Danielle Nicole Brown one, the whole back of it is like blue.
Oh no, wow. That's terrible. Yeah.
You can tell the difference in quality.
Yeah.
That's pleather, not leather.
There you go.
Well, and as much stuff as I put into those tote bags, like I went to a baby shower once and was the only person who didn't have a baby. And they did one of those, like, how many of these items do you have in your purse kind of thing?
Mary Poppins.
I won. And I was the only one. It had things like, do you have a stamp? I had a stamp in there. Like weird, weird things that it asked for. And I had them.
That's funny.
Everybody was like, why do you have all this stuff? It's not like you have kids that you need to care. I'm like, I am a well-prepared person.
You don't know. You don't know what you're going to need.
I know. My purse probably weighs 20 pounds.
You're like Ali Sheedy from Breakfast Club. She dumps her purse out on the couch. Just a waterfall of stuff just coming out.
Absolutely. Mine's organized. That's the sad organized. Thing.
How funny. That's funny.
Okay, so I know we were going to talk about something else.
May the 4th.
May the 4th, there we go.
Let's
go.
Yeah, May the 4th.
Got off on a tangent there.
No, it's all good. May the 4th. Is this Tuesday? Correct me if I'm wrong.
You are not
wrong. And as we all know, May the 4th be with you, Star Wars Day. List of things that's coming to Walt Disney World for Star Wars Day starts some places tomorrow, starts some places on Saturday, but it's a lot. There's a lot of things to choose from. At Disney Springs, there's going to be the child, LBY, little baby Yoda, in my heart and mind. Mini dome cake. From Amorettes with vanilla chiffon cake with cookies and cream mousse. It looks so cute. And I just have to say that I got the Falcon and the Winter Soldier cake from Amorettes for my birthday, just so that I could like take pictures of it because I can't eat it. But it was beautiful. It was gorgeous. So I fully support Amorettes and whatever they're doing over there. The Ganachery is going to have a milk chocolate Millennium Falcon pop with crispy pearls. She looks gorgeous. At the Polynesian, they're doing a Star Wars soft serve sundae with galactic gray vanilla soft serve, chocolate cream cookie crumbles, chocolate drizzle, white chocolate pearls, brownie pieces, and Stardust sparkle, as well as a Millennium Falcon chocolate accent piece.
Wow.
Sounds decadent. I'm into that. I don't know about gray, but whatever.
It's delicious. The gray stuff is delicious from what I heard.
Definitely.
That's true. You have not tried the gray stuff.
I haven't tried the gray stuff.
No, they have it. They had it at a Village House, I believe.
Oh, okay. That's right. I forgot about that.
It is. It's cookies and cream. It is cookies and cream. Mm-hmm. So I don't know what over at Walt Disney World.
I think it is there too.
Yeah.
Well, it's at whatever the Beauty and the Beast restaurant. I forgot what it's called.
Yeah. Yeah.
BRS.
We're looking at some lightsaber churros.
Yes, I'm hoping they have these. They better have these at Disneyland because
it would be such a waste if they didn't.
I know, and you know what? Those little holders, I first saw them years ago when they had them at the
Star Wars Weekends.
No, in Japan or China, one of the Disney's over there. They had them out there first, and I'm like, oh, these are awesome. And then, yeah, they had them at a Star Wars Weekend when it happened the next time at Disney World, but I haven't seen them at Disneyland yet.
No. So I hope we get them.
I hope so too. Cause I want to get like 20 of those holders. I want the holder. Yeah. So I'm hoping they're flavored cause they're blue and red. So
yes, blue and red for light side and dark side.
Red all the way.
What else? Galactic Swirl Funnel Cake. Black and white funnel cake with strawberries, space dust, and candy rocks.
That looks good.
You know what? I have to say the one thing I miss that they had during Star Wars Weekends was they had the Darth Vader cupcake and the whole top. I mean, you could leave the cake part. Like, I'd be fine without having that because the whole top, all it was like a peanut butter mousse type frosting. Oh my gosh. That was like the best part. Just the I'm like, I just want the peanut butter. I'll just eat the top. But then it was like coated with dark chocolate. So, that was good.
Oh boy. I love peanut butter. I love peanut butter so much.
Me too. I like honey peanut butter. That's my favorite.
Honey peanut butter. That got some right there. Yep. Heck yeah.
Yum.
I've even been known to take a teaspoon, long, you know, the long ones for like iced tea glasses, and just eat, because Alton and I eat two different kinds of peanut butter because he likes crunchy and I don't. So he's not going to eat mine. I can just eat it out of the jar.
So funny. All right, what else do we have going on here? There's going to be some interstellar sweet and crunchy popcorn, which sounds good to me. Dark Side Chocolate Creation, malted milk chocolate mousse dome with raspberry mousse, topped with almond slivers and chocolate shortbread cookie. That one looks like Darth Maul's head, everyone. Mm-hmm. So I'm 100% on board for that. I love Darth Maul.
Me too.
Love Darth Maul. They, love him.
They had something, not, it wasn't like that, but at Tomorrowland Terrace, it was like Darth Maul, you know, had like little nuts, kind of like how it's sticking out for his, you know, little horns and stuff. Yeah. But it was like a spicy chocolate. And I forgot what it was. It was good, but yeah, it had that chocolate had a real good kick to it. So I want to try it again to see if I want to try it again because I totally forgot how it was. I just remember the chocolate being so spicy.
That sounds good. I love like Mexican hot chocolate with the spice, the cayenne in it. So good.
A little bolita.
I do that when I make some at home. Sometimes I'll add a little bit in there just because it's so good. It makes it a little bit more fancy.
Yeah.
I put peppermint schnapps in mine. Good. I highly recommend it. Peppermint schnapps and hot chocolate's very good during the winters.
Yes. It is. That's true. It is.
Yeah.
And you know, it's funny, if you go to Germany where, you know, schnapps is from, they don't have peppermint schnapps. That's a completely like American thing. Mm-hmm. They have all these other flavors, but not peppermint.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Sausage schnapps, cabbage schnapps.
Kind of like the fortune cookies, you know, not really Chinese.
No.
Yeah, I know. That's American.
And then what else have we got? So I think they're going to have this at Disneyland, Bubba. I really do. I don't see why they wouldn't.
Exactly. Why wouldn't they?
But they're doing a Darth Vader Stein. I don't know if you guys ever, I don't think I have it here. I think it's in Michigan. Back like two, there we go, the Stein. The like two.
I thought they sold these.
I thought they did too, because I had the Boba Fett one.
I have one.
Yeah. I have the Boba Fett one. I don't have this one, but I would, if they don't have this here at Disneyland, I will be shocked.
Wait right there. Hold on. Wait right there.
Yeah.
I see it right now.
Yeah. Because Galactic Grill is going to be open when Disneyland reopens. There's the Boba Fett.
Yep.
It's going to be open. I don't see why they wouldn't have it. It just makes sense. Who knows?
Yeah, I think those are cool.
I love those things.
All right. This is the Stein, correct?
Yeah, yes. That's it.
Yes, that's it. Got a lightsaber. Okay, they said on here they're not, this is, they've never sold these before?
Oh, no, it doesn't say that. This list is for Walt Disney World, not Disneyland.
Oh,
so I'm just saying, I would think they would have over there as well.
So let me show it off real quick. Yeah, this is the Stein. You can drink out of his head, which is fine. And I love the handle because it's his lightsaber.
So
that's probably one of the coolest parts of it. So, and it's for ages 8 and up. So just letting everybody know.
There you go. So that's going to be available at Hollywood Studios. On the day, it'll be available at the Backlot Express. Oh, all locations on May 4th and 5th. And then after May 4th, Backlot Express, ABC Commissary, and Rosie's All-American by the Tower of Terror will continue to have those for purchase. So if you make it down there, not on May 4th, but still want to celebrate your Star Wars love, they'll have them for you then.
Yes.
So that looks like everything that's a highlight, in my opinion.
There's nothing announced for Disneyland yet.
I haven't seen anything.
Except they are having a shopping event May 4th and May 5th. I don't know if it was, I think it was just for pass holders only, but I'm not definite. I did happen to get in the shopping event because we're going to be there May 4th. So, and there's this merchandise is just
for the shopping event. Any merchandise that's left over after the 4th and the 5th, they will sell inside the parks and in Downtown Disney. So
nice.
Yeah. So I can't wait to see. There's going to be new hilts, new pins, new shirts, all sorts of new stuff, they said. So I can't wait to see this lightsaber hilts to see which ones they bring. I'm hoping they bring the Dark Side Rey hilt, which folds out.
Yeah.
That would be awesome if they have that. I'm sure it'll be $500, but oh, just to have that one would be so awesome.
That's one thing I haven't done yet. Like, I want Ahsoka's blade so bad, but I just can't. I can't. Like, if I could have Ahsoka's blades.
You can buy the legendary, the legacy.
Yeah, exactly. I could have Ahsoka's blades, and it would cost me like $500.
No, it will not cost $500.
Isn't it really expensive?
No, it's only $4.99, not $500. No, it's not $4.99. It's like $200, maybe $150 to $200. Yes, for the hilts.
Each? That's like $500.
Well, how many do you want? I know she has two.
Ahsoka has two.
They're two different ones.
I think they do sell them as a pair for like $350, $400, I believe.
That's still like 150 pins that I can have.
Hey, you're the fan of her, not me. So I'm a dark.
I have to could I have 11 more Captain America pieces of art Ahsoka's?
Yeah. Or that. And then not only that, you have to buy the right crystal for it. Oh, you get a crystal for it. Never mind. Yeah. And when you do buy one, you get a crystal.
Yeah. But that's all I have on May the 4th. And hopefully we'll get some updates from Disneyland before the day, but.
Hopefully. Yeah. Because I want to see some of the merchandise. I did see one of the pins looks pretty cool. And then the Disney shop released some stuff today of that, what they're selling on May the 4th. Some cool shirts and a nice Baby Yoda Mandalorian key. If you collect those keys.
Obi-Wan.
Yeah.
And the Bad Batch premieres on May 4th on Disney Plus. So hopefully we'll get some Bad Batch.
I know Al John can't wait for that. I can't wait for that. That's going to be awesome.
It's going to be great.
You know what I can't wait for is the Loki show to start.
Oh my gosh.
Loki. I did enjoy the last episode of Falcon and Winter Soldier. That suit was amazing.
It broke me a little bit.
It did.
I was crying. I was a mess.
My jaw dropped to the floor when a certain thing happened too. So I don't. No spoilers on here, but something made my jaw drop big time on that last episode.
Yeah.
I won't say what though.
I actually know one of the boys, the younger of the two boys that plays Sam Wilson's nephews.
Nephew? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So cute.
I know really? Him. Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, I love that storyline.
Over at Rockstar Academy of Dance, where I was working, he's one of the boys that dances on the dance team. Mm-hmm.
Oh wow!
That's cool. Where I know him from.
I love it.
Yep. So he's a cool kid, and what's funny is his mom had posted on Facebook this past weekend a picture of him in a Captain America costume when he was a toddler, because that was his favorite character. I know. And of course he gets to hold the shield during the show, you know? And I was like, can you imagine how exciting that had to have been?
I might cry right now. That's amazing.
I'll send the picture to you, Kat, so you can see it. It's cute. Yeah. Aaron's an awesome kid. So I hope he gets to be in, you know, future shows or movies that they do.
Well, I heard they might be doing a movie now. So we'll see what happens.
With Malcolm Spellman. I'm so excited. This is my official petition to let Shaka King direct it. If anyone wants to talk to me about Marvel, you know where to find me.
And I always still call him Papa Doc from 8 Mile. I always call him Papa Doc from 8 Mile still. I don't know why.
I love it.
Well, I think we covered everything, right?
We did get breaking news this morning that annual passes may be coming back at the end of the year, according to Disneyland President Bob, or not Bob Chapek.
Ken.
Ken Pot Rock. Sorry, these Pot Rock Chapek sounds
weird. Too much.
Yeah, I'm like, ah, just keep it to one syllable, guys. Come on, we're trying to do a show here.
Everyone's last name is Smith now.
I know, yeah, Smith or Gray or something. Just keep it one syllable. But so apparently this is new to me too, that D23 started their own new podcast, and he was on the show this morning and said that, you know, there was something that sunsetting the annual pass holder program was something that had to be done because they didn't know when the park was going to open. I know they've been always talking about redoing the annual pass holder program, so this was the perfect time to do it. And then he said we should have something implemented by the end of the year for annual passes. Nothing set in stone right now, but yeah, that's good news. Good news from, you know, he hasn't been president since the park's been open. So they hired him when everything was going on. So, so far, right foot in the right direction.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's good.
I also recommend that podcast, the D23 podcast, Jeffrey Epstein. And I don't remember who else hosted. I just love Jeffrey. He's a wonderful human being.
Yeah, I follow him on
Twitter.
They
talk about, he's the best. Yeah. They talk about things other than food, like things that you don't get from us. So once you listen to us, then go over there and get the rest of the news from them.
And then when you listen to that, listens to Cat's podcast, Eat the Picture, because the last episode was the best episode of the year.
Clue?
I could do a whole one-man show with Clue.
I love it so much.
Right now, I could roll credits and I could start the movie by myself and I can end credits and do exact word for word. I love that movie to death. It is just amazing. So definitely listen to that podcast.
There is only one movie that I know from beginning all the way to the end, and it's Beauty and the Beast, because I'm not kidding. I know I have had to see this movie more than 200 times.
Oh, wow. That's a lot.
Oh my gosh. There was one year where I was watching it, like I spent an entire summer watching it every single night. Like I'd come home from work and it was like late at night and I was wide awake and I'd like pop that in. Because of course it was a DVD back in the, I still have the DVD.
Just hold still.
The old big cases that they would come in.
Oh, yeah. I still have all the VHSs of those. In my mom's basement.
Those things are worth $1,000 on Etsy. You go on Etsy, people are selling those for so much. It's crazy.
Well, my brother's getting married. My future niece or nephew will have their college paid for that way.
Yeah, sure. Right?
You know, and I watched Little Mermaid the other night, and I completely forgot the movie. I just haven't watched it in forever. And I'm watching it, I'm like, how come I don't remember this at all?
Yeah.
So it was just, you know, so I got to start catching up on the classics now.
Special. This is very, very unusual.
What? Alton and I, when we used to only go once a year before we had annual passes, we would, like ramping up to our trip, we would watch all of the DVDs, like the vacation DVDs. But we also watched all the Disney movies. So like every single night was a different one. So we'd watch everything from, you know, Cinderella to Hercules. I mean, it was crazy.
That's what I do with pandemic. Go ahead.
Oh, I was just going to say, when the pandemic started and like Disneyland closed and I was here, but I live alone. Nobody come and stalk me, but I live alone. And when I was here by myself, like in isolation in California, and I like, couldn't see my friends and I couldn't go out and I couldn't go to Disneyland, the first thing I did was like turn on YouTube and search Disney TV specials. And I watched like 60 Disney TV specials from like the 70s until now. Like the opening of Space Mountain in the 70s with Lucille Ball's daughter, and the Muppets go to MGM when MGM was opening, and like the Drew Carey at Animal Kingdom when Animal Kingdom was opening. They're all on YouTube, you guys. It's the best. Wow. It's so good.
Oh my gosh, I got to find that Drew Carey one.
It's
I
so
haven't
funny.
Seen that. That's awesome.
It's so funny.
Well, I think we finally covered everything.
One last thing.
Okay.
I don't know if this is a real thing or if it's a mirage, but there may or may not be a 70th anniversary Cinderella carriage popcorn bucket at Disneyland. Bubba, I expect you to come back full details with this next week.
I was looking forward to right before the show. I couldn't find it. I found the 60th, but I could not find the 70th.
This is from
at all.
Disney Lifestylers on Instagram, who posts a lot of different merch things. And she says that someone spotted it and bought it in the park. It may be real. It may be Photoshopped, the old one Photoshopped. Who knows? But if it's out there, good luck to whoever wants it, because I want it. It's so
That's
cute.
Cool.
So post it up, push it up, or put it up towards the camera. I want to see it closer.
It's like pink.
Okay.
That's cool.
So I think I found that one. So this is a Cinderella Princess popcorn bucket from Tokyo Disney. So.
Oh.
That's what they are saying that is. I'm not sure if it's accurate, but we'll find out tomorrow.
Yeah. Started at Disneyland.
So, yeah. And then there is a new popcorn bucket that they did announce also today. The Steamboat Willie popcorn bucket, but of Minnie. Yes, Minnie. Minnie Mouse. So it's the gray and black Steamboat Willie Mickey, but with the daisy in the middle. So
I know that.
Do you have that? See, that's what I was asking. So I have the black and white one, but I didn't see a daisy one. So I don't know if they had it when it came out.
Oh, wait, maybe it's not. I think it has a bow.
Has a bow? Yeah, this one has a daisy because the original one, she had a daisy in her hair instead of a bow. So I'm not sure. They're saying it's new. It's going to be an annual pass holder bucket. So you can have to have your AP. Make sure you link your AP to your Disneyland app, which everybody needs to do. That's in order for you to get reservations and tickets. Make sure you use that app. There's actually a good story, too, which I'll share. 10 ways to use your app when you go to Disney. And it's a lot of great stuff that you need to know. Because, like I said, they're trying to get everything touchless right now for the time being. So use that app. I definitely will be.
I have heard that it kills your battery on your phone. So make sure you bring a power bank with you.
Yes.
Because you will need it.
Always. No matter what kind of phone you have, you need a power bank. Luckily, this one, the battery lasts long when it's on, a battery saver. Like we took it to Touch of Disney and I only charged it maybe for 20 minutes when we were sitting, but it still lasted the whole day. So
you've got a Samsung, right?
Yes, I have the Note 20. Yes, something like that. But I also have a backup phone, and I don't like app because of my Instacarting. I like to have an Android and an Apple because the Instacart runs better on Apple. A lot of things run better on Apple. I just don't like the way it's used. So that burns fast. I can only use my screen for like an hour and then it's down to zero. So,
wow.
I don't know if it's like that for the newer Apples. Well,
which one do you have?
The 6 Plus. It's just a 6
Plus.
Oh,
it's
an older one.
It's old. Yeah.
It's an older one. I'm sorry, I got an old phone.
Before I upgraded to the 12, I had a 7 and it would die in like 45 minutes.
Yeah.
I always had to have it plugged in, always. But this one, when I treated myself to this one, it lasted the whole day at Touch of Disney. Okay. But I do have, I bought into that fuel rod nonsense back in the day. And so I love those things. So I carry that with me.
Yeah, our friend Michelle had one when we went. We met Michelle over at Touch of Disney and we had a blast. I'm glad we got to hang out with her. She misses everybody. She misses Kristen. She misses you a lot. but we had a really good time. At Touch of Disney, we got to eat at Lamplight Lounge, and man, did I get tipsy. I don't know if I posted a live video, and I had four drinks, and these were Hulk smash punch in your face drinks. Like Ernesto, our server, didn't mess around.
What did you drink?
They do have the hidden drinks, but I forgot what I had. I know I had the Fun Wheel. I had 3 of those and the alcohol was massive on those. So apparently they put a splash of 151 on top. Ooh. Yep. Yeah. So he's going to post it. Yeah. It was fun though. I had a really good time. I didn't. Oh, thanks for all this. Me eating my lobster nachos. I wasn't a big fan of how they did the lobster nachos on mine. So maybe it needed the hair. Maybe it didn't. I don't know. But Yeah, thank you, Al John, for posting that very good video I passed. But no, I mean, look, we had a great view too. I mean, it was we did make reservations when we're going back May 3rd with my sister and her family. So I'm not going to drink as much this time. But I have that. I will. You know what? I think I might. I had 4 drinks, and I think that's the limit. Next, I don't think I'll ever go past 4 drinks. If I do, I won't be able to walk out of the park.
Yeah.
But thank you for the great time, Lamplight Lounge. Ernesto, our server, recommend him when you guys go. He's awesome. It was his first day back too. I'm like, your first day back is on the last day of Touch of Disney. So.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, at least he got to experience one day of working during a Touch of Disney.
Yeah, get him ready. So yeah. All the cast members are so happy. Yeah, on social media, when you talk to them at Touch of Disney, I have a few friends on social media who are just so happy that they're going back to work. They got to go to the park yesterday and today. And, good for them. I can't wait to see you guys.
Well, not much longer.
No. Less than 24 hours or less than 12 hours or more than 12 hours, the gates will be open. So remember, the park opens at 10, not at 8 or, no magic hours or anything. So from what I understand, after May 13th, they will be opening till 9. That's according to my buddy who works in guest services.
The inside track.
So yeah, they're in mid-May, they'll start staying open later, but right now 7 p.m. is the closing time.
It's crazy to think of that they close so early. Used to the parks being open late,
except when it rains.
Yeah.
When we were there and it closed. Kristen came. Yeah.
Yes, that's what happens, and it rains and it floods the park and they tell you go home.
Sorry, folks, Disneyland will be closed to drain and clean America's favorite family fun park. Yeah, it was kind of crazy that night. But they closed 4 hours early, or 3 hours early.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Well, I think we finally covered everything.
One more thing. No, I'm just kidding. We're done.
We hope you enjoyed today's show. If you haven't already, make sure you like, subscribe, and click the notification bell. You can find us on your favorite podcasting platform, whether it be Anchor, Spotify, iHeartRadio, or any of the others out there. And if you want to help out the show, you can do that for as little as 99 cents a month, or you can be like our top donor, Lindsay, and donate for as much as $9.99 a month. You can support the show also by shopping our Amazon as well as our Disney store link too. Bubba, you want to tell everybody where they can find Dining at Disney and you?
We are on all major social media platforms, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube. DiningAtDisney.com is our website. But just search Dining at Disney. You will find us all over the web. You can find me on Instagram. Like I said, I'm going to the parks May 3rd and 4th. So I'm going to be posting a lot of videos of me crying once I walk into the park. And walk into Galaxy's Edge and finally ride Rise of Resistance. Oh, I can't wait for that. So follow me on big_Bubba_B on Instagram. And now that today they introduced the Disney Wish cruise ship. So if you want to start planning that cruise, planning that Universal trip or Disney trip, talk to Kristen right here, themeparksandcruises@gmail.com. She'll book you immediately. So that ship looks amazing, by the way. They went all out.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
I can't wait till they give the agents a little bit more information on some of that stuff.
Did you say agents?
Agents.
Oh, agents. Sorry. Sorry. I thought you were being real specific.
No, travel agents. Okay. They're supposed to be giving us a little bit more information on the ship. Yeah, but
sounded like you said travel agents.
Yeah,
I can't wait for them to give the Asians more information.
Yeah, a little more. Yeah,
give Asian information.
I thought you said that.
Oh my god!
Just give it all to me. Just give all the info to me, the producer. I'll take care of it. Give Al John Asian information.
I was like, our producer's Asian, so we're in the clear.
That's right. Yep, got
it. All right, Kat, where can they find you?
You can find me on Instagram at Catastrophe, CAT_ASTROPHE, or on my podcast, Eat the Pictures, every Tuesday, wherever you listen to podcasts. And make sure to check out the Disney List every Sunday, live on Facebook with Kristen and Al John, and catch our friends, WDW Park Hoppers, Park Hopper John, Park Hopper Sid, talk about everything Walt Disney World on their podcast, and Disney Parks podcast with Tony and John, talking about all things Disney Parks. Also, for Facebook fun, check out our friends, the Disney Dorks and the Sorcerer Radio Fun Zone.
Until next time, I'm Kristen. With me was Kat and Bubba. Bon appetit.
This podcast is not affiliated with the Walt Disney Company or its holdings and is intended for entertainment purposes.
Thank you to everybody who watched the show live and those of you that joined us in the chat. We appreciate all your comments.
Thank you guys.
I wish I could see them.
That's weird. You can't see them. No, Joan Crane's been commenting or been chatting a lot. So is Michelle.
Park Home's at nine.
Whoops, I said 10. Sorry. It was 9.
9-7.
Oh, well, we could edit that.
I'll just leave this part in.
Good. Thank you. Because I'm an idiot.
No, you're fine.
Okay, and Taylor's here to correct me.
That's good.
The show's done. Knock it off.
I know you do.
That's Taylor's job, is to keep you in line, bub.
I know. She's my fact checker.
you need fact checking, bro.
We need fact checking around, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then all the stuff that we mess up on, we just scroll at the end. Like, oh, here's... Thank you, Taylor, for your fact checking right there. She'll just email it to Al John.
Knock it off.
Oh, gosh.
All right. We're going to sign off, guys.
Okay, we will see you guys.
Skull Rock Podcast, talking all things Disney with your hosts, Al John Go and Dave Bossert.
Do you just love to learn more about the magic that embodies animated films, theme park attractions, and more? The all-encompassing universe created and produced by the genius of Walt Disney has spanned nearly 100 years and counting.
From his earliest film endeavors with the Laugh-O-Gram cartoons and the Alice comedies, to the creation of Mickey Mouse, to the first animated feature film, Snow White and the Seven Dwarves, and then dreaming up Disneyland, Walt Disney continuously raised the creative bar, and today his company has carried on that tradition as a global entertainment juggernaut. I'm Dave Bossert, artist, filmmaker, and author.
And I'm Al John Go, musician, podcaster, and radio guy. Every week, Dave and I will explore the entertainment galaxy that is Disney with insightful conversation, stories, and special guests talking all things Disney.
Listen to never-before-heard stories and behind-the-scenes moments from some of your favorite Disney films, theme park attractions, performances, books, music, and so much more from knowledgeable, insightful, and thought-provoking hosts and guests. Hear the latest news about Disney past, present, and future.
Skull Rock Podcast is your go-to source for the magic we all love. Skull Rock Podcast. Visit skullrockpodcast.com.